stopping by. This is Deeptima, and if you haven't noticed, I'm back on YouTube and I have been posting videos quite frequently. So if you don't want to miss out on my recent uploads, make sure you subscribe to this channel and make sure you hit the bell button which is right next to the subscribe button so that you get an email notification that I have uploaded a new video and you can come and watch it and like it and leave your comments. You know the drill. So I look really crazy in this video. I just came out of the shower like half an hour ago. I haven't blow dried my hair. I just let my hair like air dry. They're all wavy and weird looking. No makeup on my face. So this is gonna be a raw video. In the sense, I'm gonna talk to you guys while I get ready. Because the last two videos were voiceover videos. And I feel in voiceover videos, sometimes I'm not able to express myself fully. So I thought today I'm gonna make a get ready with me, but I'm gonna talk to you. So let me just put my hair behind my ears and let's get started. I've already moisturized my face using the Body Shop Vitamin E Intense Moisture Cream, and I think I should apply an eye cream also once. I am still in the process of redecorating this room, and I think in my next video, like after the Sivana video, I think you would not see this pink wall. I'm getting it all whitewashed because it is very difficult to color correct in this pink wall. And pink wall, I'm not a very girly person. I don't like pink of everything. So I'm like, I will get my walls white so that the camera focuses on me more. I don't know. Maybe, you know, it'll help me in white balancing the video or something. So, okay, I'm using this Innisfree Orchid Eye Cream. I am using anything which is lying around me. My makeup is scattered all over the place. So, yeah, I'm just applying this eye cream under my eyes. So, I'm just gonna make a small warning. This video is going to be very long because I am in a very talkative mood right now. And I haven't talked to you guys in a long, long time. So, yeah. Also, I remember reading a comment on my video asking why I applied a highlighter before my foundation. So today I'm gonna answer that question. So when I apply this highlighter under my foundation or concealer, I'm trying to achieve that very natural, subtle glow. It's like you're glowing from inside. Your face looks really nice and dewy. I have like really, really dry skin. So I try to minimize powder products. Like I'm trying to minimize the usage of powder products. So this is a very nice creamy product, although it is not very intense in your face, but works fine for me. So okay, I don't have a mirror. All right, so I have my mirror. So I'm being very, very liberal with applying it. I'm just, you know, just putting it on the highest points of my face. Okay, do not be alarmed. It will all look good once I blend it out. I'm gonna blend it with my fingers only. Guys, there are no rules when it comes to makeup. Just do whatever you like, you know. Just follow whatever you want to. You don't have to follow my video exactly. Now I want coverage, but I don't want to use too many products to get the coverage. So I'm using my Chanel foundation. This is Perfection Lumiere. So yeah, this one is in the shade 20 beige. And I am going to apply it with a beauty blender. I like this foundation because it gives a matte finish but doesn't dry out my skin, and after it has settled down and warmed up on my face, it looks very, very natural. So I really, really like this foundation. I'm gonna take a little bit, and the trick to no makeup makeup look is you don't want to cover everything, yet you want your face to look fresh, bright and dewy and healthy. That's the word, healthy. So what I like to do is I just concentrate the foundation on the center of my face, and you can see I have taken quite a lot. The foundation is a little runny, not runny, but very creamy, liquidy creamy. So a little goes a long, long way. I'm taking my Pat Beauty Blender and just blending out. not mentioned, but I'm assuming it is understood that this is a wet sponge. So after that, I am just going over this foundation with this brush. Although it is not needed at all, it is nicely blended, but I just like to make sure it is blended. I don't have streaks. Now, usually when I'm getting ready and I'm in a hurry, I just apply my MAC Pro Longwear Concealer under my eyes and I'm good to go. But because I have this yellow base on my face right now, I'm gonna use my Maybelline Fit Me and applying very little bit of it under my eyes just to cancel out the shadow and darkness. That's it, not more than that. Next, I'm using a compact just to set the concealer. I don't want it to crease. Had I been using just the foundation, I would have skipped this, but I think I need it right now. This look is not at all planned. I'm just going with the flow. There is a wedding nearby, so I can hear people laughing, screaming, singing, and there are like songs playing in the background, which actually reminds me of my wedding. Like, it's been 2 years since then, the songs have not changed. They are playing the same exact songs that we were playing at our wedding. Just dusting off some extra powder. So I recently got this Maybelline. This is Fashion Brow Cream Pencil in the shade brown. This one is in the shade brown. I haven't used it yet. I just opened and swatched it on my hand. I feel it's very light. And I honestly feel this is not the perfect brown for Indian skin tone. I don't know. So let's just try this out. And I'm not very impressed with it. The previous pencil that Maybelline launched, the eyebrow pencil, I hated it. I just hated that pencil because it was so dry, and I don't know, maybe it was the tester at the store or something, which was like just really dry. I didn't feel like buying it, and this is not very expensive. This is just for 175 rupees. So basically the SA convinced me to buy this. He was like, ma'am, it's not that expensive. And I was like, okay, fine, de do, let me try. Kaisi hai? Let's give Maybelline pencil, eyebrow pencil, a try. So yeah, I think this is good for the transition if you like that faded eyebrow effect, but for the overall eyebrows, I don't think this works. Hey, don't be scared, I will be blending it out. First, let me keep my foundation aside, because with all the mess, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna drop or break something today. Going back to my Sivana eyebrow, 3D eyebrow, not 3D, this is Sivana Cute Automatic Eyebrow Pencil. Just blending out. To be very honest, I really don't feel the need of going in with a darker color. I think if it is like a no makeup makeup look, my face is gonna stay very neutral. So I think this eyebrow color would work. So I think we'll leave it like that. Is it working? Is it working? I think it is working. I think we'll leave it like that. So while deciding what to do for my eyes, I found this Color Bar All Day Waterproof Eyeshadow Stick. And I'm ashamed to admit that I have had this for months. I haven't used it. And it just, my heart aches to find makeup products that have been with me from a long time and haven't been opened up. I have this in the shade Ornament. So let's put this. Oh, it is a nice color. So let's just put, can you see that? So let's just put this on my lids. I just hope I don't go, I don't get carried away with this look. So I'm gonna apply it on the inner part. I can't even see it. I have a feeling that this might break. We started from the inner corner and then I ended up applying it all over my lids. But that's okay because the color is pretty. Can you see it? guys, I know some of you would say that this is too much makeup for a no makeup makeup look, but this is what it is. I can't help it. Some of you might like it, some of you might not like it, and it's difficult to please everybody. So I'm just blending out this color a little bit. Also, if you are of my age, you would know with age, you know, I know I'm sounding like a very old person, but yeah, like I do feel that my eyes are getting little hooded, like, see. The eyes are getting little hooded, and also I haven't had proper sleep in the past few days. So what I like to do is I like to define the crease so that my eyes look little youthful and little, you know, defined. To define the crease, you can go in for any color. You can use like a peach color, you can even use like a slightly reddish brown, you can use a chocolate brown, anything that suits your complexion. Today I'm going to use this Reveal 2 palette because it was lying next to me, and I'm going to use this color over here. This is a pretty color and we will be using this one. And I'm just taking a little bit of this product. I'm using a very light hand. I'm just defining the crease so that the eyes look open. I know the brush looks really ugly, but it works. Next, I'm using another new product which you guys have seen, the baked eyeshadow from Sivana. So I'm gonna use this as my highlight today. So which shade? I think I'm gonna mix these two shades, like these two, the pink and the champagne color. Mixing both. Okay, so because I would be doing a video after this Get Ready With Me, I think I should fade up the eyebrows because the color is already fading off, as you can see. I cannot find my Sigma eyebrow palette, the eyebrow kit. What do you call it? Eyebrow powder? I can't find it anywhere, so I'm using my Maybelline again. Okay, at least this palette is being used. I don't use this palette very often. Because I feel the shade could be, I don't know, I'm not very fond of this palette. So yeah. Also, I really don't understand why, like just small rant, you know, I really don't understand why people, you know, they leave. Sometimes I do get, most of the times the comments are really nice from you guys, and I really love reading those comments. You know, reading good comments, they actually make your day very positive. It makes you feel very positive. So I really like reading your comments, and thank you so much everyone who leaves lovely comments, and I try my best to reply to most of you. But sometimes, you know, every once in a while you would get some really annoying messages, like hate. I can't say haters, or I can't say hate messages, but sometimes people leave really nasty comments, and by reading them you can definitely make out that the comment has been written specifically to hurt you and to just spoil your day. But I don't get bothered anymore. Like, sometimes I do, I won't lie to you guys, but most of the time I really feel sorry for that person who has left the message. Because I feel whatever you are writing on any social media platform, or whatever you're saying to someone who we don't even know, the comment doesn't define me. Although you are saying nasty things about me in the comment, but that comment doesn't define me. Actually, that comment shows your character, it shows your personality. So why would anyone want to portray a negative image of themselves online? I don't know why. Sometimes I feel really bad, and I feel maybe that person is going through a rough day and he or she is just trying to feel better by insulting me. So what I do is I usually delete it, because I know then people start commenting and they, you know, start fighting. So to avoid all that fight, I just try to delete it. Sometimes I leave it there, sometimes I do reply back, but I try to delete it if it's too hurtful and if, you know, it can hurt someone else also. So I just delete the comment. So be very careful of what you're saying to someone, because a good person would never intend to hurt anyone, be it your real friend, online friends, or anyone like me who you don't know, you just watch on your laptop or mobile or TV or whatever. So yeah, I just wanted to say that. I just wanted this thing to be out of my system. So yeah, I just said it. So if you're trying to hurt me by posting mean comments, it will not work, because I don't really care. See, the eyebrows look so much better now. I really hope you are enjoying this video, and I just love talking to you guys. Like, this is like my time when I'm alone at home, and I really like to talk to someone. And because this is like right now, it's like really late at night, so I can't really talk to anyone. My mom, my sister, everyone is asleep, and I'm pretty sure most of my friends, I don't have a lot of friends to be honest, but the few I have, I'm sure they must be asleep as well. Can't call Sumit again and again because he's busy in office, so I get really really lonely during this hour, so I like to make videos. So I'm gonna give this mascara another try. This is the Falsies Push-Up Drama. This is like waterproof version. This mascara does not come off. Like, I slept with this mascara, it did not smudge, and when I tried taking it off, it was a task, I tell you. So I'm just giving this mascara another try to see if I like it. I usually start liking any mascara once it has dried out a bit. Like, whenever I try a new mascara, I never like it. I just like the mascara when it is, you know, a little dry and it's been used a little bit. I don't know if that's weird, but yeah. So sometimes I deliberately wipe off the firecrackers. So sometimes I deliberately wipe off the wand just to get the extra product off the wand, and it actually works. Look at the difference. Can you see that, guys? Let me do that on this eye also. Every time, every single time. We'll fix that later. I made it red. I'm also looking for ways to organize makeup. Did I say makeup? Jewelry. I'm also looking for ways to organize jewelry. If you guys have any organizing tips, please share it with me. You can just, you know, take a picture and send it to me on Instagram, or you can even tag me on Facebook. I would love to get ideas from you all. I remember sometime back, like when I was like newly married, or I think last year when I was like really really regular on Snapchat, I said that, you know, it's very difficult to keep up with the new routine and stuff. And someone suggested me that whenever you wake up, the first thing you should do is make your bed. That way you will have a more productive day. I started doing that and it actually worked. So I actually listened to you guys. We have this like community where we try to help each other. I share my, you know, a little bit of my personal life. I share my makeup tips and tricks, and you guys share same stuff with me. So it's like we don't know each other, but still we are somehow connected. So I'm again using this nude palette, and I'm gonna take a brown color. Which one should I take? I think I'm gonna take the same color that I used for my eyebrows, this one. I'm just gonna very lightly make an eyeliner. Although I can leave it like that, like the eyes look really nice, although the mascara is slightly clumping. But anyhow, I'm gonna just take this and make a really really thin liner. See, it looks so beautiful. Let's do the same thing on this side. Now, I like to call this makeup like a cheating makeup. The liner is there, you can see it, but it is so blended and so blurred that it's not there. A really soft makeup, but it does require a little bit effort. I love the eyes, looks really nice. I used to do this a kind of smoky eyeliner when I was doing my business system information management course, and I used to really like it. It looks so nice, it makes your eyes look so innocent. So just gonna do that on the bottom lashes. Just on the outer corner. You don't have to go all the way in. You don't wanna close your eyes. So for my blush, I decided to try something new and I found this NYX blush. This one is in the shade Peach. Alright, so I'm gonna use this blush with this brush from PAC 302 brush from PAC and just applying it on the usual spot. So what do I have here? I have this Lakme Absolute Sun Kissed Bronzer. So just to warm up my face, to be honest guys, now I think this is not a makeup look. This is definitely a makeup look. So what should I name this look? I really don't know. Let's see. I'm gonna take this and just bronze up my face. I usually mix both the shades together. Tap off. See, what I do, see, everyone has different face shape. For me, what I like to do is I don't bring my bronzer beyond my eye. Like, my eye ends here. So the blusher, I mean not blusher, the bronzer should end here for me. This is what I do and I like how it looks on me. So everyone has a different face shape, so everyone will have a different routine. So yeah, and over here again, applying the bronzer. You don't have, I mean your face naturally is not like one even color. So if you just apply compact like or foundation concealer, you will not get that natural look because your face is not flat one color. So it is really important to apply bronzers, highlighters, like just balance out. You don't have to go crazy with it. If you like to go crazy, then you can. Moving on to the lips, I'm using NYX lip liner in Natural and I'm just gonna apply it. For a very very natural look, you can just apply the lip liner, fill it in, apply lip balm on top and you're good to go. I think I should do that today. I'm gonna use this Lakme Absolute Cream. Yeah. I'm gonna use this Lakme Absolute Creme Lipstick in the shade Bare Pink. I'm just gonna apply it very lightly. This is a nice color, why haven't I used it? The scent is exactly like MAC lipsticks. So because everything is like so neutral and simple, I think we do deserve some highlighter. So what should I use today? I think I'm going to use this eyeshadow. And I'm going to use this champagne color mixed with the white to create a customized highlighter. So I'm using Elysium brush in Fractional and I'm just going to mix it and apply. I'm just... I hope it works. Let's see. Can you see? It does look pretty. It does look pretty. I think this palette is amazing. You know, you can use it. Okay, I think I applied way too much highlighter. So this palette is really nice guys. This was it. This is in the shade 04 and you can use it on your eyes, you can use it as a highlighter as I have just applied and you saw it does work really nice. So pretty much it. And this completes the look. I think I'm done. I'm not gonna do anything else now. So this is your pretty face ugly hair makeup look from Deeptima. So should I fix my hair? Should I just leave it? So this is the look, guys. I really hope you like this look and you really enjoyed this chatty get ready with me. If you did, then please let me know in the comment section and I will do more of these in the future. And make sure you subscribe to stay updated. As I said in the beginning of the video, it will mean the world to me. So make sure you subscribe to my channel and like this video. You can even share my videos with your friends and you can invite them over to subscribe to this channel. I really, really hope to talk to you guys again in my next video. Till then, take care. Lots of love, hugs and kisses to you all. And take care. See you soon. Bye-bye.